Yo guys, it's Abitibu, Little Bro here, and today I'm going to show you something kinda stupid, okay? Look at all of these contraptions. You basically go, what do they do? They do something useless, okay? Useless and laggy. Oh my god, today we're not gonna do good redstone, nor good commands. Today I'm going to show you the 4 worst ways to generate a delay. I mean, the 3 worst ways, and then the 4th one is the proper one. Many people on Discord ask me, Nico, how do you create scoreboards? What's scoreboards? Whatever, I don't even know what scoreboards are. So, I wanna answer all of those questions, but I wanna do it in a funny way. And that's why, we're gonna first create some stupid stuff with everything but scoreboards, and then we're gonna use scoreboards, and I'm gonna show you how much easier it is. So we're gonna start with something really easy that you all understand, repeaters. So as you can see, now we have some repeaters, and this repeater lines goes all the way over here, and then it hits the redstone lamp, and when it hits it, it lights it up. Then the line goes all the way to here, goes back, goes all the way back, and loops around. Okay, this is not so compact, okay, but it's not my fault, okay? I don't do redstone in years, okay? It's been so long since I even touched redstone, so, you know, it's not my fault. I'm a command blocker, not a redstone guy. So, this loop is exactly 10 seconds long, so as you can see here, there are 3 ticks, and here there is 1 to compensate. So, in theory, this is gonna be 10 seconds long, because a redstone tick is equal to 2 game ticks, and a game tick is equal to 20, a second is equal to 20 game ticks, so 1 second is equal to 10 redstone ticks, so 10 seconds is equal to 100 redstone ticks, I think, and 100 divided by 4, because these things are 4s, is 25, so as you can see we have 25 repeaters, but this one is a 3, so this one is a 1, so in total we have 100 redstone ticks, that is 200 ticks, that is 10 seconds. I hope I made myself clear right there. So that is pretty easy, and you may say, Nico, what is this? So I found another way to create a little bit of a delay, and these are observers. So back in the early days of when observers were first implemented, observers were so OP, because there was no delay, so you could transmit redstone from one side to the other with no delay. But then they added a delay of 1, meaning that a repeater, the delay of a repeater with 1 tick is the same of the delay of 1 observer. So if this method used 25 repeaters, since this one has repeaters with only 1 tick, this has to use 100 observers, because each observer is like a repeater set to only 1 tick though, not to 4, only 1. So we need to use 100 repeaters, and that is what I've done. There are like 100 repeaters all the way here. There are not actually 100 repeaters, because I have to compensate for these 6 repeaters over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Wait, are they 7? Yeah, I have to compensate for these 7 repeaters here, so there are like 93, I think, observers, if I didn't mess it up, so that is exactly still 10 seconds. And as you can see, this is kind of a crazy design, but the next one is even crazier. So as you can see, how it works is that basically there is like some redstone going here, and it powers this repeater, because, you know, he finds a change, and then this repeater finds that this one has changed, so he powers this one, and the loop continues until it reaches the redstone lamp that gets powered, and then the redstone lamp powers this little line right here that goes all the way back to square 1, and then it goes here and powers this again. Now it's a little bit glitchy, because I don't know how to use redstone, but as you can see, if you look at the 2 lines, it should be pretty much, yeah, it's a little bit unsynced, probably because I forgot one of the observers. I'm gonna try to fix this. Let's try doing this and let's see what happens. I'm scared, but now we have to reset everything, so we're gonna do something like this, and then something like this. Let's reset it. So I made this little contraption over here, so they both reset at the same time. Look at this, I'm smart. And now we do this, and let's see if this works. I removed one observer to compensate, because I think I changed something. Now you have to look at the 2 lights. So let's see if they light up at the same time. Hopefully, tell me that they do, please. Oh, yes, they light up at the same time. I mean, kinda. I don't even know. Yeah, but that is synced. So these 2 are both 10 seconds ticks, which is kinda amazing to think about. Now we're gonna go with this design. This design is not linked to these other designs, because, you know, it's impossible to predict. It's a random delay, because it depends on the speed of your computer, I think. I don't even know, but I didn't want to play around with this too much, because I was going crazy at this point. This is the data merge. So if you don't know what this is stupid, okay? This only lags your computer, okay? So basically what this does is that when this is powered, it's gonna activate this command block right here. So the command block in front of it. So it's gonna activate this one right here, then this one is gonna activate this one, then this one is gonna activate this one, blah 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 blah, going all the way, and all the way, up to here. Look at this. And then this one is gonna set this block to redstone block. This block to redstone block. When this block is set to redstone block, this is gonna get activated, and this is basically the reset, because when all of these blocks are activated, we need another line to deactivate them. So this is the line that deactivates all of these blocks. Look at that, it's crazy. And then what other things you do? This sets a block to air, and I think it's the block at the start. It sets it to air, so it's a reset. No, it sets this block right here to air, and then this one also sets the block at the start to air, so this one. And then, after all of this line that resets everything is done, there is this command that basically sets this block right here to deactivate it, because it's the only one that we didn't deactivate, this one. And then there is one last command always in this chain that basically sets this block back to redstone block. So the loop is repeated. It was so crazy to make, it was so fun to make, but still so useless, guys. Like, why would you use any of these three designs? You may say, well, Nico, I may use repeaters, but no, like, seriously, using 25 repeaters for something so stupid like 10 seconds delay? What if I want you to do 100 seconds delay? So, if you want to do 100 seconds delay, you need to use 100 repeaters, you need to use 400 observers, and I don't even know how many of these you have to use, because, you know, you see this, these are 100 command blocks, only this line is 100 command blocks, and it's only a 6 second delay, only 6 seconds and something, okay? So you need to do so many commands to do like 100 seconds, it would be like impossible. So now we're gonna go on the fourth design, that is actually the good design, the one that you must use, and the one I wanna teach you about, because it's really simple, okay? So these are all of the commands that are in the design. These command blocks must be executed only once, and this one must be always executing. The funny thing about this is that we can create a delay of 10 seconds, or we can create a delay of 1000 seconds, or a delay of 10,000 seconds, but the setup will always be like this. There will not be more command blocks or more stuff. So basically the proper way is using scoreboards. So the first thing that we need to do is create a scoreboard. So scoreboard objective add count, that's the scoreboard, dummy. Basically dummy means that it's not gonna change itself, we are gonna change it ourselves. So just do this command block, you just have to do it once, okay? And then this is the other thing that we need. We need an entity where we are gonna save the score to. So we are gonna summon an area effect cloud. You can use an armor stand, but I'm gonna use this because it's, you know, a little bit better, it lags less, but you can use an armor stand if you want. I made it so the tag that he has is counter, so we can rely on it. And also this thing, the duration thing, don't worry about it, I only put it there so that the area effect cloud is infinite. Because if I don't put it there, it will despawn like after 1 millisecond. So if you put it to this, this is the highest value you can put it, it's gonna be alive for 3 years. And not 3 in-game years, 3 actual life, in real life years. So, you know, it's gonna take a while to despawn, so you just leave it like this. Just copy this command. And now, after we did all of these commands, these 2 commands, we just have to do it once. Now that we did them, I already did them, we're gonna have a counter entity. So as you can see, we see every entity that has start counter, we're gonna get this area effect cloud that we generated. So now what we're gonna do, we're just gonna add a score of 1 every single tick, because this is repeating and always active, to the entity with the tag counter that we just created. So basically what this is gonna do is gonna do this little funny effect. As you can see, the entity, you know, the score of the entity is always going up. Then we're gonna basically detect, we're gonna execute as the same entity, so the tag counter, that has a score of count that is higher or equal to 200. And if he has this score, then basically what he's gonna do is gonna set block a block to redstone block. Basically the block is this one, so it will power up the whatever this is, the redstone lamp. Then always if the score is equal or bigger than 200 or greater than 200, it's gonna reset its score back to 1. And then if the score is like 5, it's gonna set this block back to air, so the redstone lamp is gonna be powered for a bit. So as you can see, we're gonna see it live. We're not gonna set it to air, actually, let's set it to grass block, because it will look a little bit better. Now we're gonna see it live, 200, as you can see, and then when it went to 5, it set it back to grass block. It's pretty easy. Now what if I want to do a delay that is bigger than 200? It's like so simple, we can do 2000, and then we can go here, and do 2000. Then we can go here, and we can keep this to 5. So now we have to wait till the counter goes to 2000 to make it work. Now we're gonna try to wait, why did it get reset? Oh my gosh, look at this, guys! I was like, why does it get reset before the time? Because this command block gets executed by this redstone. No, this is not supposed to happen, look at that. Stupid command blocks getting executed when you don't want to. This is like, redstone is so bad, like, no, seriously. Yeah, but seriously though, guys, did you see that? The command block getting executed by the redstone wires, it was so bad. I never want that to happen before. That is why I don't use redstone in my commands, I mean. But yeah, that is why it didn't work before, but now it's gonna work. So if we set it to 1900, as you can see, it's gonna go up to 2000, it's not gonna get reset before. It's gonna go to 2000, you're gonna set it, and then you're gonna set it back. If you want the lamp to be activated for more time, you can set this to like 100. So let's do the same thing again, let's do like this. And now it will stay activated until we reach 100. So basically, you can do anything with this. As you can see, now it's 100, it gets deactivated. And you don't even have to worry about space. Look at all of these stupid designs. Anyways, I'm gonna leave a download of this stupid thing in the description. So you can play around and have fun with it. But I propose you guys one little challenge. This is gonna be an amazing challenge, and I want you guys to do it. You should create a really, really weird way to create a delay. So I used these four ways. I want you guys to create a fifth one that is actually pretty weird. Just tweet me the design, or send me a direct message on Discord, I don't care. Just create a new design and send me it, and I'm gonna review it in another video when I get many of them, if I get many of them. So this is the challenge I dropped to you guys. Will you be able to create a design? It doesn't have to be a compact design, it has to be crazy, okay? It has to be stupid, it has to be useless. But I wanna see what you guys come up with. I wanna see how you guys are creative, because you know this design right here with the data merge block, this was never used before, and it has a reason not to be used before, because it's kinda stupid. I want you guys to create one like that, but with your ideas. That, you know, there is a lot of stuff that could generate delay, or maybe you could put like some more design one into another, maybe also even cooler. So guys, I dropped to you guys this challenge, I hope you really enjoy it, and have fun doing it. But yeah, this is it for today's video. I hope you learned something new, and you also learned what not to do with redstone. Look at that. That is really, really bad. Hope you really enjoyed, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next video of doing useless stuff with Nico.